This video will go through the process of creating a blank NVivo project file, ready for you to start with your own research. Once you've got NVivo started, you're ready to go. All you need to do is click on the New Project button. This will open a two-step wizard to help you get started. The first thing it's going to do is ask you for your project title. I'm going to call this Training Project 2022. You'll notice this forms part of the file name, Training Project 2022.nvp in my case. You can choose Browse to change where you want this file to be saved, but I'm happy with the default folder, so I'm leaving this as is. It's really important that you store your NVivo project in a local folder. What I mean by this is that if you use OneDrive, iCloud, Box, or some other cloud service, you should not store this project in a folder that is live synced. This can cause an issue with your NVivo project, leading to the corruption and loss of data. Keep it simple and store it on a local hard disk or drive that you have access to. You've got the option to put a project description in here if that helps. The final thing I need to do on this particular screen is set the text context language. You'll see I've got several languages as my option, and in this case I'm going to choose English UK. If your language is not listed here, it doesn't mean NVivo does not support it, just choose the other option at the top. Generally speaking, NVivo has very good compatibility with any left-to-right language. It can, however, struggle with some right-to-left languages like Arabic. Once you've set your text context language, you can click Next. On this screen, we've got some important decisions to make. First of all, you can choose to make your project autosave by default. If I choose yes, this will mean NVivo will continuously save my project as I work. However, this does remove the undo option, as changes are written directly into the database underlying your project file. So just be aware of this consequence if you choose to save automatically. I'm leaving this at the default of no for now. Next up, we can ask NVivo to display reminders for us to save our project. This is set to every 15 minutes by default, and I'm going to leave that at that as well. The final options we have relate to project recovery. So I've got this set to every 30 minutes. What this means is that if I click save at any point, a backup of my project will be saved in the recovery file location. Once I've done that, I can continue working. If I were to click save in 25 minutes time, it wouldn't trigger that recovery file to be created because it has not yet been 30 minutes since I last saved. However, if I click save in another few minutes time so that 30 minutes has elapsed, the recovery file is created. This all happens in the background and you won't really be aware that it's going on. In short, it's important, if you are actively working in a project, to set this recovery to every 30 minutes so you're always reassured that as long as you're clicking save regularly, those backups are happening. Secondly, it can be worthwhile increasing the number of recovery files that are created. It's important, however, to note that these take up disk space, so you may want to be careful in choosing your recovery file location to make sure you have enough space for this. Once you've set all of these options, you can click Create Project, and NVivo will open with your new blank project file. It will always start with this tutorial, but you can choose Skip Tour to get started right away with your project. One other final consideration before we end this video. Your NVivo projects will be precious to you. They contain all of your research data and your analysis. You should save this file regularly and back it up regularly. I advise including the day's date in the file name when you're keeping multiple copies, as this will always ensure that you know which is the latest and the most up to date. One easy way to create a backup is using File and Copy Project within NVivo. Here, you can choose to copy to a Windows, Mac, or NVivo Collaboration Server project file. If you're working on Windows, you're likely to just want to copy this to another Windows project. You can choose Browse to choose where to store this, and then, as I already discussed, put that day's date in the file name. In this case, it's 2022, January the 25th. Once you've set where you're copying to, you can click OK. And NVivo will copy that project and store a copy of it in the new location. You will, however, still be editing the one that you already had open. So you can see here, I'm still in my original training project. How often and how many times you backup is completely your choice. And it's relative to how much work you're doing on a given day. If you're only doing a couple of hours work, you may not feel that's worth a backup. However, when I was working through my thesis and working very long days, I used to backup 3 times a day, roughly every 4 hours, so that was the maximum number of hours of data and work that I could lose. Of course, I never did need any of those backups, but it was always reassuring to have them.